the end of week one. I'm sore, my neck's sore, my shoulders are sore, my wrist is sore, my back's sore, and I'm exhausted mentally and physically. But it's great, I learned it loads. My technique was completely wrong, so correcting it. The main thing is that it can't twist, the beater can't twist in your hand. And the grip is mainly the thumb, the first and the middle finger. The middle finger should meet the thumb, meet the base of the thumb, around there. Your bicep should be completely relaxed, and the movement is completely in the wrist. So, Sory's had me playing one note like this for ages, and standing next to me and feeling my arm, making sure that there's no tension there. Which is really hard because I've been playing basically between the thumb and forefinger and using my arm like I would with djembe, using my upper arm to create the motion. So adjusting is really funny and it's hard, but it's working, and I can see that my hands look more like a balafon player. I don't know really how to describe that apart from just seeing videos and just seeing that it looks more authentic, or just like it should somehow. So yeah, I had to use my wrist and this part of my arm, but without it being too tense. And I need to grip it enough that it doesn't move like this, but not so much that I'm squeezing it. Sometimes when you're doing faster things, then you can relax the second, third and fourth fingers. You just kind of bounce it across the keys like this. Sory says that if you're not holding it properly, if it's spinning round, it's not making the right sound, whereas if you grip it properly and use your wrist, it's making the right sound. I think what he's meaning is just that extra kind of attack from this to this. So yeah, sitting up straight, your body always facing forward, and when you're going up or down the balafon, not twisting and turning too much, and that the movement should just be in the wrist. So when if you're descending like this, you shouldn't sort of. What he's noticed is that my shoulders were bouncing when I was going like this, my whole body's moving. So he's got me to just keep my shoulders completely stiff, even stood behind me, and kept my shoulders to my sides like that, so I couldn't use them. So we've been doing all these exercises as well, some stuff like this where I'm just playing one note, see, and then playing the chord with the other hand, or the rest of the chord with my right hand. Also arpeggio. We've been doing lots of that, and again moving them up and down, and I'm noticing that the trick is to just kind of flick your wrist from one side to the other, so you're not moving your whole arm, which is what I'm doing. And also, I used to, if I was doing a roll, or not a roll, but something like this, have the stick slightly apart like that to give myself space, but that's wrong as well. The stick should always be facing forwards, and so you have to go. Anyway, it's really hard, I can't quite do it yet. I don't think that happens so much where you do those kind of rolls. It's usually two with one hand, one with the other, like this. What else are we doing? Learning new stuff. Can't think of much more for now. Mind's been a little bit blank. I'm going to leave it at that. So yeah.